to talk about what I believe in, because I feel like we all have this sort of void within us that we constantly are searching to fill. Whether you know that you're doing that or not, we're such intelligent creatures that we have to find reason for everything, including why we're alive. I attended church for a while as a Christian, but I remember never feeling as though that was the right thing for me. I never felt comfortable knowing that there was somebody watching me up in the sky and had my whole life planned out for me, and that when I died, I was either gonna go to heaven or hell based on how and what I did. There's a lot of Christians and people who have religions that they follow that are very, very opinionated about what they believe in. And I'm jealous of you. I'm so jealous that you are that confident that you believe that 100% with your heart. I almost don't believe you. Like, another thing with Christianity that I didn't like, that didn't appeal to me, that appealed to everybody else, which I thought was crazy, is the fact that when you die, your consciousness just lives on forever in heaven, and you are a spirit in heaven, and you can continue living your, I guess, life in an afterlife. And that never appealed to me. That always sounded very terrifying. Think about it. Okay, so let's say you're at a concert and you love this concert and you're having such a great time at this concert and you're there for a couple of hours and it's the best concert you've ever been to. Eventually, you go home and then you get to talk about the concert and how wonderful it was and, you know, reminisce about it. But imagine if that concert lasted forever and you were never gonna go home and you were just gonna keep living that concert forever and ever and ever. Does that sound appealing to you? Does that make you want to go to that concert? I know it's sort of a weird way of explaining it, but that's exactly how it feels to me. But what I did want to talk about was Buddhism. When I first started learning about Buddhism, I didn't know much about it. I knew that it was about meditation and peace. But when I started to learn more about Buddhism and what they really believe and what the lifestyle that they truly live, I was blown away. Buddhism teaches nothing but compassion and love and understanding. And the thing that's different with Buddhism compared to any other religion is the fact that they don't believe that there is a God that's controlling and all-powerful and created them. It's all about the nothingness. Which brings me to my next point about how some people feel that they need to fill this void within them, this emptiness, and they fill it with religion, they fill it with drugs and alcohol, they fill it with food, they fill it with bad behaviors. When in reality, you should embrace that. You should embrace that void. When you first come to terms with the idea that life has no meaning, that there is no God, that when you die, and that's it, it can be a very depressing feeling, and it could feel like, wow, what's the point, you know, if I'm just gonna die? But the point is that you are here, and you are alive, and you are conscious, and you are a living creature who gets to experience whatever you want. You can go and do and see anything that you want in this world. And people get so caught up in the past and they think about things that people have done wrong to them. They hold so much hate in their heart and they look back and they're just so caught up in the past that they're not really living. And then you have other people that are caught up in the future and trying to plan, and I'm gonna work my ass off right now so I can save money so that I can have a better future. Everybody's working for the future, working for the future. But who's living in the now? Who's saying, you know what? My past is over. My future hasn't happened yet. The only thing that I have right now is right here in this moment. Who says that? I learned that from Buddhism. There's nothing more liberating than the feeling that nothing has to be done and that you are to just be. It was a very peaceful moment for me when I first absorbed that idea within myself that I'm not being tested, I'm not being judged, I just am. It felt so good to know that everything just is and you don't have to fill that void. you can embrace that emptiness and just feel at peace with it. You know, we're all conditioned to behave a certain way. We're a product of where we grew up. We're a product of our surroundings and our environment. And it's very easy to get caught up in things that don't really matter. The only thing that really matters is you, yourself, like in how you feel about things and what you want to do with your life. I actually feel that deep down we all have this universal feeling of love within us, and we know what's right and we know what's wrong in our heart. And if we just keep doing what we know is right in our heart, and we give and we show compassion and we show love, that's the type of energy that you're going to attract. You can let go of grudges. You can let go of hate. You can let go of bad experiences that you've had, because they mean nothing. The only way that they mean anything is if you make them mean something. You create your own reality and you don't even realize it. What makes a person beautiful? It's a very subjective thing. So if you label something as good, bad, evil, wrong, that's what they're gonna mean to you. I think people need to free themselves of this way of fitting everything in to a descriptive box, when that's not how life is. Life is not black and white. Nobody knows anything for sure. And I feel like if people stopped trying to control their lives so much and stopped trying to make sense of everything, everything would just fall together. And as a person that has suffered from depression, there have been times where I have felt very unhappy and not really knowing why. And I would feed into that idea, and it's a very vicious cycle. If you find yourself unhappy, you need to find out what it is in your life that is making you unhappy and change it. Life is forever changing. Nothing ever stays the same. So if you find yourself in a situation that you're unhappy in, or you find yourself feeling very down and upset and sad, as cliche as it sounds, this too shall pass. You will not forever feel this way. If we felt the same way that we did about everything forever, then we would be like robots, and then there really would be no point. But I think the point of life is to just continue to change and evolve and learn and live in the now. Be happy with who you are and be happy with what you have. And not to say you can't have goals, but you need to constantly remind yourself that the only thing that you'll ever have is what you have right now. And so I think that that's the most important thing. If you're doing something and you have a gut feeling that what you're doing isn't the right thing to do, you need to follow your instincts. And you can't always go searching for what you want and how you want to live your life in a book. Sometimes you just have to listen to yourself. Life is very short. Live in the here and now and start appreciating what's going on in our immediate surroundings and just embracing life for what it is. So I guess that's my piece of advice. Maybe somebody else feels the way I do or has some advice for me. Who knows? I guess the main point I'm trying to make is don't be afraid to live. And if you feel like something is holding you back in any way, and you don't feel like something is right in your life, you need to investigate that. Don't just do things because other people tell you that's what you should be doing. Use your own brain and make your own decisions, because you have more control of your life than you'll ever know. Just follow your passions. If you want to check out more of my YouTube videos, please do. I don't really have a theme to my YouTube channel. I'm a very do whatever the fuck I want type. And that's how you should live too. I guess that's kind of the point. Do whatever you want. Why do you have to have a theme? All right, never give up, guys. See you next time. And I put on some inspiring music to help me along the way, because the song actually makes me want to cry. Oh my God. Listen. Wow. Anyway. Okay, this is better.